Right, good day to another practical session here at Electronic Engineering. And the idea is to give some guidance on how to construct the common collector amplifier. In the theory class, the common collector amplifier can be either PNP or NPN circuit, and depending on the orientation of your transistor, your circuit components is going to be handled in a specific way. But for us, the main thing is we've got a circuit for the practical circuit. We've got breadboard, and we're going to then follow the procedure and construct the circuit. And again, the idea here is more to focus on how to use the breadboard, because we often see students orientating it like this, making power lines on the inside of that breadboard, expecting the circuit to be correct or not. Now, the breadboard has got a standard, and if we do not use it as a standard component, you are going to be penalized in terms of your marks, and secondly, chances of your circuit developing some kind of a deviation from the original theoretical circuit and eventually not working becomes greater. So we want to assist you guys and make sure that you do not walk into that trap. So I've got a transistor, and in this case it's the 3906, and it's got three legs, the base, emitter and collector. Always check in the data sheet about the orientation of these legs, and the idea then is to orientate it so that we can put the components around the transistor as designed. So you will notice, different from the common emitter, the emitter here on this transistor is on top, it's not at the bottom. The reason is electron flow from positive to negative, and the transistor symbol indicates that the emitter will get the electrons and then it will be going through the collector to ground. So there's no connection on the collector to ground other than a piece of wire, and we can then use the transistor like this. So it's upside down from before, so I see it as the emitter, the base and the collector. So I make sure the emitter sits on top, and just to make life for myself easy, I bend the three legs like so, so that the base comes through on this side, because I would like the circuit to look like the one in the book. And then the collector, I can put it in there. So I put it in like so, the emitter on top, the base I bend through, and I make it on my left hand side, and the collector I make it on the right hand side. That should assist in not making it very confusing. Now, red line on top, plus. So I've got the red line going to my power supply, and we've got the blue line at the bottom, 0 volts or ground, common, and I got that going to the 0 volts of the power supply. So there's a circuit, and there's the breadboard. So plus needs to go there, ground, 1, 2, 3, 4 grounds, 1, 2, 3, 4 grounds is all going to come to the blue line here. Remember, ground symbols on a schematic implies that they are all connected together to the same place. In our case, we use the blue line on the breadboard here, and we use the red line on top for our plus VC or VEE, which is 12 volts. Okay, so how can we do the circuit? Very easy. And I always use the term very easy because electronics is not supposed to be difficult. We are using it every day in all kinds of technologies. And if you find it difficult, then something is wrong in the way that you are understanding the technology. So what I've done just now is this connection here, ground to the collector of the transistor. I use a wire jump. No need to try and bend that leg until it fits here. It will not stretch that far. That is very bad for a component to do that. Then we have, we can decide what side we want to start. Let's see. We've got the signal generator, which is an off breadboard component or instrument. It will be connecting to C1. So if I find C1, which is a 1 microfarad capacitor, it's not this one, it's one of the other ones. That's it, 1 microfarad. Then again, make sure the positive, the straight line on the diagram, connects to the base of the PNP transistor. And my base is this side, and I connect it like so. And then for clarity, and just to make it nice, I can show you nicely how I've done that. Okay, so it connects from here to here, going nowhere. Ne? Check note, I do not connect it to ground, that would be crazy, because where the heck are you going to put your signal generator? So it must go to nowhere at this stage, the signal generator and the oscilloscope will connect to that point. Then we have on this side the base, and we have on top the emitter. So I can take the base, I can see 33 kilo ohm, the color coding for that, orange, 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 like so. And if we have it in the breadboard, we can now connect that from the base, which is down there, all the way to the positive. Right, just to make it less confusing to the new viewers. Welcome back to you guys as well. And then we have a 1 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm resistor that is connecting from the base to ground. So 10 kilo ohm, brown, black, orange, old favorite. And that resistor connects to the base, but it also connects to the ground. You will notice these two grounds are now connected together as well, connecting to the black, which is going to my power supply. I have a 1 kilo ohm resistor that must come from the collector, emitter. Easy to get confused when you are used to the common emitter circuit. And the 1 kilo ohm resistor plugs in like that, connecting the emitter to plus 12 volts. So we've done that. Then we are left with a 10 microfarad capacitor, which should be this one. That is it, 10 microfarad. Also check the orientation. Negative is usually the short line, but if you have it cut equal length, then be careful to also check the body orientation. So negative always goes to the load, positive comes to my active part of the circuit. In this case it goes to the emitter, and from the emitter it should go to somewhere in an open space on the breadboard like such. And then we use a 1 kilo ohm brown, black, red. That is my load, and that comes to ground. So to recap, orientate your breadboard so that the positive on top, negative at the bottom, it aligns with the way the circuit looks like. Orientate your components so that you can have easy access to the base, the collector and the emitter, and then start in a logic fashion, usually left to right, with the components that is being connected. And if you do that correctly, your circuit may look something in the order of this example that I've got here. And that is how you assemble the common collector amplifier. Thank you very much.